Hello, welcome to another tutorial on Mathematical Shortcuts. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about cube roots. In the previous tutorial, we saw how to obtain the square root of a perfect square. In this tutorial, we are going to see how to obtain the cube root of a perfect cube. You already might have learned about obtaining the cube root using factorization technique. Here, we are going to learn about the shortcut how to obtain the cube root. Before that, we need to know the cube of a number. Suppose number is 1, 1 cube is 1, 2 cube is 8, 3 cube is 27, 4 cube is 64, 5 cube is 125, 6 cube is 216, 7 cube is 343, and 8 cube is 512, 9 cube. 7, 9, 10, 1000. Okay. How do we do it? Now, suppose a perfect cube ends in 1. Suppose the perfect cube ends in 1, the cube root also will be, cube root also will end in 1. Right? Suppose the cube root, perfect cube ends in 8. Cube root ends in 2. Suppose if it ends in 7, it ends in 3, if it ends in 4, 6, 4, Now, if it ends in 5, cube root also will end in 5, and the perfect cube ending in 6, will have a cube root which ends in 6. Now, 9, will have 9. A to 2, 2 is 8. Okay? And if it ends in 0, the cube root also will have a unit digit 0. So this is something which you need to know. So if you notice, except for 2, I forgot right about 3. If it's 3, the unit digit will have 7, right? So except for 2, 3, and 7 and 8, the digits will remain the same. So if it's 2, the unit digit will be 8, and if it's 8, the unit digit will be 2. Right? And if it's 3, the unit digit will be 7, and if it's 7, the unit digit will be 3. For the rest of the digits, the unit digit will remain the same. For instance, if the cube, perfect cube, will have a unit digit of 4, the cube will also have a unit digit of 4. A perfect cube having a unit digit of 5 will also have a unit digit of 5, and so on. So how do we use this understanding to obtain a cube root of a perfect cube? Let's take an example. Let's take a perfect cube 5, 4, 8, 7, 2. So what is the step? So try to understand this step. The first step is to group the last three digits into one group and rest of the digit into another group. So you have 8, 7. So notice the last digit in this group 2. If you have 2, the cube root will have a unit digit of 8. So, and notice this number 54. 54 lies between the perfect cube 27 and 64. With cube roots 3 and 4. Now take the smallest cube root, which is 3, and write it. So cube root of 5, 4, 8, 7, 2 will be 38. Take one more example. Let's say consider one perfect cube 1, 5, 7, 6, 2, 5. Okay, as in the previous example, break the number said that you have last three digits in one group and rest of the digit in another group. So you have 625, the last digit being 5, so the unit digit will be 5 again. And consider this number 11157. Now this lies between the perfect cube 1000 and 1, 3, 3, 1. And whose Q roots are 10 and 11. Now take the smallest Q root, which is 10. So, write 10 here. So, the Q root of 1, 1, 5, 7, 6, 2, 5 is 1, 0, 5. Easy? If you have any doubts regarding this tutorial, you can leave a comment in the comment section. I'll get back to you. And for